What's up, you guys? Oh my gosh, it's been a while. And I tell you what, this is like the biggest confidence booster in the world when you first log on to Facebook and you do a Facebook Live and it says that there's 5,000 people online. So like normally when you do a Facebook Live, it tells you like this is how many people are online like at the moment right now. So your odds are, and that's actually a really great tip for those of you who are catching the replay. So like I don't wait a few seconds for people to hop on. I just jump right into it. So a good tip for those of you who are catching like the very first beginning on the replay is when you're doing a live video, first of all, don't wait for people to hop on, like jump right into it. But secondly, you want to check and see like various times and days that you go live, because there are certain times of the day, hey Karen, and certain days of the week where you can actually see like at the very top of when you are just getting ready to go live, it'll say like whether you want to post it to your timeline and or to your story, yes to both. But it's a really great tip to take note of how many people that it says are on live at this time, because if the numbers are lower certain days of the week or lower at certain times of the day but higher in others, you can note that and note that that's a really great time for you to go live. So just a little quick tip for those of you who like to hop on early, who have notifications on. Speaking of, if you tap the top of the screen or hit my face, you can actually click the three dots and click following and turn on notifications. So if you want like to be in at the very beginning, because I jump right in, like I don't wait, I don't sit there and wait around for people to hop on, I jump right in. So those of you who have notifications on and know to like hit the button right when I go live, you always are gonna wind up getting some little quick tips that are off topic a little bit, but are always it's going to be really good nuggets for you. So tonight I want to talk to you guys about something that I feel like is really common in not just network marketing. Hey Troy, yeah, you caught me live. Not just network marketing, but this is like, I don't care if you own a brick and mortar business, if you have a traditional online business where you are literally like direct shipping stuff. Here's the thing. This is a problem that I think a lot of people have who work for themselves, because let's face it, the beautiful part of being an entrepreneur and in network marketing is that you don't have a boss like telling you what to do, when to do it, and like looking over your shoulder, forcing you to do things, right? And forcing you to stay productive, like be sure you only take 30 minutes for that lunch break, be sure you only use the bathroom 3 times in the 8-hour shift. Like you don't have anybody doing that. That's a good thing. Hello, amen, and hallelujah, right? However, it can be a bad thing because you don't have anybody telling you what to do. You don't have anybody saying like, hey, be sure to like use your time wisely. Hey, are you slacking off? You know, should you really be using social media that much? Hey, Brittany. Hey, you guys. Thank you guys for hopping on. So tonight I want to share with you my number one biggest tip in the whole world. If you came to me and let's say, for example, if you're on my team and you're like, but Laura, I feel like really unproductive. I feel like I'm working really hard and I feel like I'm doing all the things and I work like nonstop, but I'm not getting anywhere. I feel like I'm spinning my wheels, right? So I wanna share with you the number one like breakthrough. Seriously, this is going to be life-changing for you. And I personally feel that everyone needs a type A friend in their life. Don't you agree? I feel like if you are not super organized and, you know, kind of a little bit OCD, just a little bit, and you like live by your calendar, if you are not that type of person, you need a person to speak into your life who is. I'm your person, okay? So one of the things that I really do very well is I feel like I manage my time well and I'm a really good planner. Okay, so have you ever heard the phrase like use your strengths for good, like use your superpowers for good? So this can be one of those situations where if you're not very good at planning and you're not very good at staying on task and stuff like that, you could choose, it's always a choice, you could choose to let that derail you and to let you spin off into like some super funk where you're not going to be very successful in your business. That's really common. Or you can tap in and realize, hey, this is an area of weakness that I need to grow. And while I'm growing and mastering this skill, I'm going to implement some things and strategies and systems in place to help me stay on the path. Look, there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, you're worthy of having the success and using tools and systems and strategies to help you do it. Okay, so I'm going to show you one. It's my personal favorite and it's free. You don't have to pay for anything. But I want to show it to you because this is something that has been like a total game changer for me. Okay, so the first thing, I think that like the biggest thing is to identify the problem. The biggest problem that people have as an entrepreneur and in network marketing is that they feel like they are on the verge of burnout. So I would love to know, like if you're watching this live, go ahead and put like a flame emoji if you've ever felt like you were just on the verge of burnout. Like I can't do it anymore. This is crazy. I'm not getting anywhere. I feel like I'm working, but I'm not getting anywhere, or like a sad face or whatever. Just let me know below if you've ever felt like that. Put a flame emoji or a sad face or whatever. Or hearts or something. Let me know. If you're catching this on replay, I'd love to hear back from you too about that, because I feel like this is really super common and most of us don't want to admit it. I feel like most of us have been there and we're like, kind of like seething inside. Like, I don't feel like I'm getting where I need to be. And I feel like I'm a fraud. Like I present myself as this and that, but I feel like I'm spinning my wheels and not getting anywhere. All right. So the first thing I want to teach you on this video is mastering your calendar, but not how you think. Okay. So y'all know that I am a huge advocate of working your business super hard, but also loving your family super hard and your friends and your spouse. And you've got to find the balance that works for you. Okay. I have been witness to a whole lot of top income earners and entrepreneurs in both network marketing and traditional businesses that they work so hard at their business and they grind. I hate that word. Hate that word, but they grind super hard in their business. Okay. Now, if you do that in a structure or systematic way, great. And I'm going to teach you how to do it in here in just a second. So bear with me. But if you are always grind nonstop, I've seen people lose their families. I've seen it cause divorce. I've seen kids like spin out and act out. I've seen businesses crumble. I've seen the like opposite effects of what you want. So like I've literally seen people work so hard grinding their business nonstop. Like literally they're not going to bed with their spouse anymore. They have like totally different bedtimes. All of the things that they used to do, they're no longer doing as a family. I've seen that where the business takes precedence over their family. So much so that when they finally look up, when they finally look up from their business and they look up from their phone, their marriage is in shambles. Their spouse is out the door. The kids are God knows what. Like it's crazy. And what's really interesting about that is that when you grind like that and you are a leader of a team, this is what gets me fired up. First and foremost, my husband is my priority. Like I will never grind my business and put that ahead of our marriage. Sorry, not gonna do it. But I work my business really hard. I'm gonna show you how I do that. Like this system that I have, I'm gonna show it to you. But what I've seen happen is that you as a leader, you are always, keep this in mind, you guys, especially if you're in network marketing, you are right now always showing your future team members, like your prospects, you're showing them, you're teaching them what is going to be expected of them when they join your business right now, before they even join you, before they even express interest with you, you're showing them what's going to be expected to be successful. So here's what I'm going to ask you to do. If you are a team leader, if you're in direct sales, if you're in network marketing, hit the share button and share this into your team pages, just your team, your private team pages. If you are an influencer in the space, like if you have people who follow you on Facebook or whatever, YouTube or whatever, who also are in network marketing and direct sales, share this out because they're going to want this information, because this is something that if you are grinding and working and like you're trying to be the Gary Vaynerchuk of your network marketing business, I mean, the work ethic is admirable. The work grind, I don't personally buy it. I don't believe it. I don't think that's healthy, okay? So let me talk about the work ethic. You can have that work ethic and have that kind of hustle, but keep it all in alignment and finding the balance. So I want to teach you guys real quick it's like a course that I could do, seriously, but I'm gonna like squeeze it into just a few minutes for you. I'm gonna teach you real quick how to time block, okay? Mastering your calendar is literally just about you have about 18 hours to work with, okay? So assuming you sleep 8 hours a night. I sleep 8 hours a night. But assuming you sleep 8 hours a night, you know, you've got like 16 to 18 hours, okay? So 6 to 8 hours of sleep, whatever you're gonna do. So just assume, let's assume you have 16 hours a day, okay? So that's about normal for most people if they get 8 hours of sleep. 16 hours is a lot of time. So consider the fact that the top person that you admire most in your business has the same 16 hours. What are they doing with their time that you're not doing? Okay, the first thing you need to put on your calendar, and you can literally listen to me and have your calendar out like right now, okay? Look at your calendar. Like if you have a digital calendar, like Google Calendar or a paper planner, it does not matter. I don't care. It doesn't matter. There's no, I've used all of them. Whatever you'll actually use, use that. Okay. So whatever you have, look at your calendar. The very first thing you need to block off is the stuff that is absolutely non-negotiable. If you were acting as if you were perfectly balanced in your work and your home, your spirituality, your faith, your fitness, all of that, okay? If everything was perfectly balanced, how would your calendar look? So some things that are non-negotiable things. So for example, if you have your workouts scheduled on your calendar, that literally should be treated as seriously as an actual appointment. Okay, so put that on your calendar. Here's the thing. Most of us, especially women, especially moms, y'all put your fitness and your personal like self-care, you put that in like wherever you can squeeze it, right? I want to challenge you, if you're a woman, especially if you're a mom, if you're a dad, you've got to make that a priority. Like set it as an appointment. Go out for a 20-minute walk around your neighborhood. Don't tell me that you can't. If you can't, like literally because of physical limitations, then you need to do something where you're moving your arms, you're moving your legs, you're doing something physical just to increase your heart rate. That's it. Hey, Amy, thank you so much for saying that. Something to increase your heart rate, something to get those endorphins flying. I mean, try to do it at the beginning of the day because it's interesting. The way you show up the rest of the day, if you put that first, is like, it's seriously amazing. Seriously, it will light a fire under you and your confidence, your enthusiasm, your excitement will come through. I promise you, everybody will notice. So the first thing you need to time block out is your own self-care. So like your physical care, okay? Have you ever heard the phrase, when you're on an airplane, this is an old phrase, I know a lot of people say it, but when you're on an airplane and the people come down the aisle and they're teaching you like what to do if the plane is going down, like, and they're usually like, okay, and when you're done screaming, grab the oxygen mask and put it on yourself first. Then get the oxygen mask and put it on your loved ones. Why would they say that? Why would they say, save your child first, do everything for your children first, do everything for your spouse first, do everything for your business first, your downline, put them first, your upline, put them first. Seriously, they don't say that. They always say, put it on yourself first. Why? Because you are useless to everybody else if you're not taking care of yourself first. If you don't have oxygen, if you are not filling your own cup, if you're not making time for yourself, you are truly squeezing in everyone else and they're gonna feel it. You're not giving your best self, okay, to them. So first priority is literally take the next day, tomorrow, put it on your calendar, something for yourself first. Time block that out. Also, time block out, like literal, like highlighters, pens, whatever. I love office supplies, so I like colored highlighters and pens and all these things. I use a digital calendar though, so my Google Calendar is like a rainbow. Okay, whatever you gotta do. So time block out appointments, okay? So for your self-care, but also obviously, like if you've got a dentist appointment, if you have to be at a parent conference, if you've got a soccer game, time block those things out, okay? So you're gonna time block self-care, you're gonna time block your actual appointments that are like on the books. You also, I'm gonna challenge you, those of y'all who are married, you probably know by now if you watch my videos long enough, I'm always like marriage and business, relationships and business, okay? If you're married, please trust me from experience, I'm speaking, block out time at least once a week for date night. Trust me, I don't care if you are broke, I don't care if you are broke. Broke is a temporary situation. Poor is a mindset, okay? So if you literally are in a temporary situation where money is not there, do something free. It's still a date night. Put it on your calendar. Make it special. Go to the park. Make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Grab some bottles of water. Go to the park. Swing on the swings. Take a walk. Find some kind of body of water, lake, pond, creek, river, whatever. If it's in your area, have a picnic. Do something. Just make it. You can make it a date night even without money. Trust me. I am a military wife. My husband and I he was in the Marine Corps when we first got married. We had less than $0 for date night, but we still, every single week, without fail, we have made time for each other on date night. Put that as a priority item on your calendar, just as if it was a non-negotiable appointment that you cannot break, okay? I promise you, I'll make it, if take anything from my videos, please take that. Okay, so date night, spouse time. Also, if you're not married, block out some time for your family. So this is something that I think is really important, like spend time with your friends, spend time with your family, make it an actual appointment. You will find in cycles of your business that you will slack in this area some, and then just flip the switch, you know, like call somebody and invite them to come along with you somewhere, right? If you're going to Costco or something. Do you have a friend that loves Costco? Do double duty with that kind of stuff, right? Like multitask. If you're going to the mall, do you have a friend or family member who would like to go with you and spend some time with you? You can do double duty on these types of things, okay? So time block that kind of stuff out. Obviously, time block your kids, so like soccer games, baseball games, that kind of stuff. Time block out homework time, okay? So like there should be a chunk of time where you've got like kids' homework and that sort of thing. So time block all this stuff. Now, it sounds like a lot, and I know you're probably thinking, wow, I'm not gonna have any time left to work on my business. Oh, friend. Okay, here's the thing. I challenge you, and I would love for you to come back to this video when you do this. Let me know, because I would be willing to bet a dollar that you find that when you have all your stuff actually written out and time blocked into chunks on your calendar, I'd be willing to bet you have a lot more empty space than you think you do. I bet you do. Now, here's what I want you to do. I love you too, Rhonda. Thank you. I want you to do this. Once you have all this stuff time blocked, okay, then you need to go in and make sure that you block out time for your business, for work. Okay, and you can actually put it on. Listen to me, network marketers especially, you work. Newsflash. You work, it's a business. If you're treating it like a business and you want it to pay you like a business, then you have to treat it like a business and put it on your calendar as work. You need to work. Work works, okay? You need to put it on your calendar as work time. So like productive time. My calendar literally says there's a chunk on my calendar, multiple chunks actually throughout the day and evening and whatever. There's multiple chunks where it says IPA, income producing activities, IPA. Write that down. That should be something that you put on your calendar as like a trigger for you. Oh, I need to do income producing activities. Income producing activities are things that move the needle on your business. Move the needle. So really check yourself. Newsflash. scrolling Facebook and watching people's Instagram stories is not income producing activity. Unless I'm gonna give you a pass, so listen. Unless you've specifically blocked like a chunk of time, I'm gonna say like 15 minutes, for you to do, I like to call it market research. So it is wise, I feel like, if you're an entrepreneur and there are other people in your space, even if they're in another type of company or another industry, if they're still in your space like network marketing, direct sales, it is wise to look at what top leaders, top earners, top influencers are doing and see not how you can copy, but see what they're doing and see what strategies or like what kind of cadence they have. What are they doing? How does their Instagram look? How often do they do Facebook Lives? How are they showing up? Do they look professional? How do they title their videos? What kinds of posts are they making? Are they posting Pinterest spammy kind of graphics, or are they coming up with their own content? Market research is very wise no matter what kind of business you're in. Spend a short time every day doing some market research. So that's basically your permission to scroll social media, but do it with intention. Do it very intentionally. Have some people's names written down where, like, okay, I want to check what this person, and this person are doing so that I can kind of just glean some kind of strategies and tactics from them. You can learn a lot by watching what successful people do and how they think, I promise. This is a good IPA. IPAs, basically, it can all whittle down to, like I said, what moves the needle in your business. New prospects move the needle in your business, okay? So getting someone new onto your contact list, people who are new, who are interested in your business or your products, new prospects, new customers, new member of the sales force, new promoter on your team, or if you're in a traditional business, another employee, someone else to go out and promote your business. It's called leverage, okay? Those are income producing activities, is when they produce, when that activity produces one of those three things. If it's not something that's going to immediately produce new business, it's not an income producing activity. Do you see what that means? So a lot of times people confuse this, because in the network marketing space, we all, oh, you need to do personal development. You need to, you know, read this book and listen to this podcast and watch these videos. Da, 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 da. Listen, you can spend a ton of time, you guys, consuming information. Please share this with your teams to let them know, because I would be willing to bet that like 80% of your team members are getting burned out because they feel like they're consuming so much information. They're always learning, they're always reading, they're always watching a video, they're always taking some free webinar or some free course or paid course or going to some seminar or whatever, and they're consuming and they're getting fat with knowledge, but they're not implementing anything as an income producing activity that's gonna move the needle in their and your business, right? So if you have team members who are like burned out, seriously, do them a favor and share this with them. So what's moving the needle are income producing activities. Now I want to give you a quick tip too. Like if you have customers who already exist in your business, or promoters who exist in your business who aren't, you know, they're not quite the leadership in terms of like, they're not flying. Maybe they want to do it just as like a little hobby for some extra income. Those, I consider those people like VIP customers. Seriously. I have a lot of promoters who just want to dabble. They just love the community. They love our tribe. They love our videos. They love our team huddles. They love the products, loving a part of it, but they're not like out there like, yeah, like they're not Braveheart, like, right? Like running up and down and trying to get they're not doing that. I consider those kinds of people like, oh my gosh, the best customers I have. I love them. So help them and your own business simultaneously by taking a look at the people that you have as customers and your VIP customers, your promoters who are just hobbyists. Help them get what they want by probably getting your products for free or at least at a discount. You know, if you have some kind of referral program in your business, use that incentive for them as leverage. So that way, you know, you can help them get what they want, but now they're out there and they're spinning. Meanwhile, you're over here working on your own income producing activities. Do you see? So creating leverage by multiplying your presence, I guess, is the best way to put it. So another thing you can do that helps move the needle on your business is consider what you're posting on social media. And I could do a whole course on social media. If y'all would like that, let me know. Because I feel like I could talk about this for 3 days straight without ever taking a breath. But real quick about social media, be cognizant of what you post on social media. Realize your posts on social media disappear after a while. Nobody sees them after, I would say, 24 hours. It's very rare for, you might have a post or two that still gets likes and comments after 24 hours, but usually most posts die within 24 hours. They're just dead on the newsfeed, right? Videos, however, I still have people contact me from catch somewhere. They catch a video that I literally did like 2 years ago. I still have people reaching out to me from videos like on YouTube or here on Facebook or a podcast where I was in an interview, where I was interviewed on. It's crazy to me. So audio and video linger. Those are income producing activities. The more videos that you do and you put out content of your own knowledge, learn something, reteach it. That's the best tip for you as far as like that goes. But using that kind of stuff as leverage, because that way it's often spinning while you're over here with your family. You're at your soccer game, you're at your kids, you're doing your kids' homework with them, you're doing all this kind of stuff that's time blocked on your calendar. Meanwhile, you have a ton of this stuff out here, like videos and other content that's out there working for you. Posting on Facebook 7 times a day is not doing you any favors. It's just not. Post on Facebook a couple times a day because let the world know you're alive. I have a sneak peek. Are you guys, those of you who are hanging in with me or those of you who are watching this long, I actually have a sneak peek for you. Type in the word DMO into the comments, DMO, if you would like the thing that I'm about to launch. It is literally my daily method of operation. It is the daily tasks that I do to grow my business every single day. If you would like that, put DMO in the comments and I will let you know when that's ready. Oh, I just can't believe I announced it for real. Okay, so that's a sneak peek for those of you who are hanging in here with me. In addition, type in the word formula if you would like, because I'm also working on and collaborating with my girlfriend, literally a formula of what to post on social media and when to post it. It's gonna be amazeballs. Okay, so just let me know if you would like that. Put it in the comments. You will literally be the first to know when that's ready. It's free. It's free, by the way. There's no cost or anything. It's just, we're gonna send it to you. But I'm really excited for that because I feel like this is something that a lot of people, they get on social media, they don't know what to post. They don't know how often they should post. They don't know if they should be posting, scrolling, learning, reading, watching YouTube videos, filling their mind with affirmations and meditations, or what in the heck to do, right? And I feel like a lot of people would be better at network marketing if they had a plan, if they knew what to do, when to do it, how to do it, what to say, and like to stop the madness. Free up your time so that you can spend more time with your family while your business becomes a well-oiled machine, okay? All right, so your homework, okay? Your homework for right now is, one, tap my face right here and hit the buttons. I don't remember which side they're on. Hit the buttons that come up when you tap my face. Hit following and hit notifications. You can also send me a friend request or follow. Just get notified when I go live because I jump right into stuff. So if you're just now like catching this or if you caught this a few minutes late, go back and watch the replay because right in the first 5 seconds, I give you a really awesome tip. Second piece of homework, go look at your calendar. Please go look at your calendar. I don't care if it's print, I don't care if it's digital. Go look at your calendar and start blocking stuff out. That will change your life. I would bet you a dollar you find more time on your calendar than you thought you had. Busy mamas, busy parents, busy employees. I promise you, you have more time than you think you do, and you can get more done if you use it the right way. And then second piece of homework is to, if you want my personal daily method of operation, what I do without fail every single day to move the needle on my business. I'm not talking about like I do my meditation. I'm not talking about that stuff. I'm talking about things that move the needle, things that will make you money. If you want that formula, it's free. If you want that DMO, type DMO in the comments. If you want the formula, social media posting formula, so like how often to post, what to post, what kind of content to post, on Facebook and Instagram, put formula in the comments and I'll send that over to you as soon as it's done. Okay. It's free. So I'll just shoot it over to you. Okay. I hope this was helpful. I have to hop off. I'm doing a business opportunity presentation for my team where I pitch the business on their behalf. So I got to go. But let me know if you catch us on the replay, if you do the calendar homework and all that kind of stuff. I would love to hear your feedback. If you hit the share button and you share this out to your teams or to your timeline, type shared below and let me know that too. I would love to thank you and give you a name shout out. In the comments, I'll come back and type hello to everybody. Thank you guys so, so much for all the shares and awesome. Formula. Divo. Oh, that's super fun. Okay, cool. It's one of those things like when you create something, you're like, would anybody actually want to know what I do every day? Would anybody want to know how I stay organized? What do I post? It's one of those things, right? We're always like self-conscious and self-guessing. Would anybody actually want this? Clearly y'all do. So thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. Remember to hit my face, tap the little three dots and follow so you get notifications when I go live next time. And I will see you on the next one. Bye you guys. Have a great night.